already.
Well, hello there, Purple Night Nation. I'm Malcolm Farrellette.
And I'm Rashad Munch.
And welcome to another episode of Purple Night News. So before we get into my absence, first we want to congratulate our very own Josiah Bunch being honored for the 7th Ward Neighborhood Association 20 Under 20. Congratulations. Yep. You know, usually we hear about, you know, the Forbes 30 Under 30, the 40 Under 40, the 20 Under 20, and you made the list. So tell us about the award.
So it's basically honoring my community service and what I did for like the 7th Ward in the community that's out here right now in New Orleans. And we're talking about what happened. Where did you go? Because you was in Washington, D.C. having a whole good time at the White House. So what happened with that?
So I had the opportunity actually last week, January 17th, 2023, to go to the White House to speak with Vice President Kamala Harris on the topic of men of color. Thank you. Just talking about different problems that go on, particularly economic empowerment and mental health. And all around, it was a great week. I'm tired, but at the same time, in San Augustine High School, we run on field and a couple of other things. But other than that, it's all good. Mm-hmm. And with that being said, let's get started with some Purple Night news.
The early signing period for college football begins on Wednesday and runs through Friday, making today National Football Signing Day. National letters of intent are available for high school recruits to sign, committing them to the institutions of their choosing. Two five-star prospects in the 2023 ESPN 300 switched their pledges in the days leading up to the early signing period. Two five-star prospects in the 2023 ESPN 300 switched their pledges in the days leading up to the early signing period. On Monday, quarterback Dante Moore chose UCLA over Oregon, and Tuesday, offensive tackle Caden Proctor chose Alabama over Iowa. The early signing period first day was chaotic, with a five-star safety decommitted from Notre Dame and signing with Oregon, in addition to Alabama snagging two five-star defenders from the same high school. The Ducks significantly rose in the rankings. On Sunday, Victoria Cantrell, the mayor of New Orleans, appeared on the CBS News show Face the Nation to talk about crime, policing, and the ongoing recall campaign against her. Cantrell was initially questioned over the ongoing problem with law enforcement, and particularly the NOPD's shortage of officers. She praised the city's effort to attract new officers and keep existing ones, and she also credited funding from the American Rescue Plan. Retention and recruitment are both important. We are investigating $80 million in public safety across the board as part of the second direct distribution of the American Rescue Plan fund that has truly been a lifeline. The Kansas City Chiefs defeated the Jacksonville Jaguars 27-20 in a divisional round of the 2022 NFL playoffs. The Philadelphia Eagles then crushed the New York Giants 38-7. The Cincinnati Bengals defeated the Buffalo Bills 27-10. And the San Francisco 49ers defeated the Dallas Cowboys 19-12. Bengals versus Chiefs will be in the AFC Championship game, and the Eagles will play against the 49ers in the NFC Championship game. In the Super Bowl, the two champions will square off. From the wild card weekend to Super Bowl, which will be held on Sunday, February 12th, here's what we know about the AFC and NFC brackets, including seedings, TV timings, and the schedule of games. Here's the Bible verse of the day. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. The Lord is my strength and my shield, in him my heart trusts. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee and will look up. Thank you and have a blessed day. Here are some ACT testing days that you should all look out for. The February 11th test is the first test for 2023. Are you taking it? Do you feel like you're prepared enough to knock it out the park for the last time? If not, no worries. You still have April, June, July, and the rest of the year to test. To all my seniors, this and April should be your last test. Take these tests to improve your score for more scholarships to college. We want to see everyone go to college with no expense at all.
San Augustine High School has had a Future Business Leaders of America chapter since the mid-1990s. Since then, students have participated in various events and conferences and represented San Augustine High School exceptionally well. The 2023 Southern Regional Leadership Conference, which took place on January 25th, 2023, in Lafayette, Louisiana, our chapter members placed very high, and some have even qualified for state conference. Those that place superior and qualify for state competition will be able to compete statewide in late March and hopefully qualify for a national convention, which will take place in Atlanta, Georgia, this summer. Congratulations to everyone who attended the conference and showed FBLA and the rest of Louisiana what St. Augustine High School is always about. And we look forward to hearing about the great things that the chapter will do at the State Leadership Conference this March. On Tuesday, January 17, 2023, St. Augustine High School student body experienced something that only occurs about once a year. And this is a sense of quietness and an early diagnosis of what some would call peace. Members of the campus ministry team traveled all across the country with the one and only Father Tony Ricard, but they weren't the only ones not present at 2600 Bitterroyo Avenue. The St. Augustine High School Purple Knights, who hosted 12 exchange students from St. Denis, France, were also out exploring new cultures and allowing their minds to be open to the unseen world outside of the United States of America. During this week-long journey, students were able to visit attractions such as the Eiffel Tower, Notre Dame, the Louvre, and more. It was an experience that will always be remembered. We look forward to seeing the next group of Purple Knights travel across the seas and embark on a similar journey. The St. Augustine High School Alumni Association Atlanta Chapter Mardi Gras Ball will take place this weekend on January 28, 2023, of course, in Atlanta, Georgia. For everyone who is going, please make sure that you take every safety precaution possible to keep yourself safe from COVID-19. Even though we are getting out of the pandemic, we're happy to see that chapters have continued to let the good times roll. Please make sure to be vaccinated, use hand sanitizer when necessary, and of course, try to social distance as much as possible. A special shout out and a thank you to the Atlanta, Houston, Washington, D.C., and Dallas alumni chapters for continuing to support St. Augustine High School. Your continuous support helps us continue to develop boys into men. The St. Augustine High School chapter of the National Honor Society inducted 20 new members into an organization that continues to recognize scholars for their academic excellence. From grades 10 through 12, inductees were inducted due to their showing of the four pillars of the National Honor Society, those being scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Speakers to the inductees and their families included President and CEO Mr. Alston Taylor, class of 1998, and other faculty members. Congratulations again to our newest members of the National Honor Society as they are welcomed into an organization that St. Augustine High School is so proud to have. Congratulations are in order to the following students who were honored and awarded at the 7th Ward 20 Under 20 Gala for serving their communities. Those students are Terrence Cormier, class of 2025, Jonathan Ashford, class of 2025, and our very own film and media crew member and Purple Knight News co-anchor, Josiah Bunch, class of 2026. The award was presented by Leon Roche, another fellow Purple Knight, and was accompanied by Mona Lisa Saloy, the president of the 7th Ward Neighborhood Association. Congratulations to these three gentlemen who received this distinguished award, and may this be the beginning of your community service to the 7th Ward and the rest of New Orleans.
Parade routes were initially shorted again this year due to the New Orleans Police Department's ongoing manpower issues. New Orleans had previously asked crews to find enough officers to supplement the understaffed New Orleans Police Department for the upcoming carnival festivities. The city has offered to pay outside officers $50 per hour for crowd control along parade routes before Fat Tuesday and $75 per hour on Mardi Gras Day. Hopefully this decision will be changed and we could get back to our long parades, or the short routes might be in our favor if the weather keeps getting colder. A state audit revealed that the LSU Athletic Department overpaid football coach Brian Kelly by more than $1 million during his first year on the job. The exact amount was $1,368, which was spread out over a series of double payments in May and June 2022, well as additional supplemental double payments until management notice in November. Kelly's 10-year contract totals to $95 million, with a $500,000 bonus each July and another $500,000 if LSU makes a bowl game. Kelly was hired by LSU in November 2021 after a 12-year tenure as a coach for Notre Dame in Indiana, where he holds the record for the most wins in that school's history. On Tuesday, the Florida College Board tried to release a new framework for the Advanced Placement course in African American Studies that the administration of Governor Ron DeSantis blocked from being offered in Florida high schools. The nonprofit organization, which oversees the nationwide advanced placement program, announced that on February 1st, an official framework for the AP African American Studies course will be released. The project has been under development since March. The DeSantis administration sent a letter to the College Board rejecting the course this month and said the content of the course is inexplicably contrary to Florida law and significantly lacks value. The Florida Education Department opposed the curriculum but welcomed the revisions even though they're still not released. DeSantis has made education and other social issues a key part of his administration. Last year, he signed into law legislation Stop Woke Act, a law that restricts how race and gender are discussed in classroom. Let me be honest here. The way this is going, African American history might be wiped off the face of this country. But in today's society, politicians try their best to make sure that we black people don't discover too much about our past.
Louisiana officials are said to be deliberately indifferent to keeping inmates past their release dates by the Justice Department. Now, I understand being indifferent to keeping inmates past their release dates, but because they have been reported to being deliberately indifferent to the idea, add something more to the statement. It also seems that others feel the same way, as according to their article written by Glenn Thrush, the department, citing evidence uncovered by lawyers representing incarcerated people, concluded that the state has known about the problem for at least a decade and has done little to address it.
Hello, Purple Night Nation. I'm Landon Bishop, class of 2023, and welcome back to Scholarship of the Week. This week, we have a little something for all of you student entrepreneurs who are interested in majoring in business and taking your ideas to the next level. The Jet Insurance Company invests in the future of business leadership in America. This scholarship is for graduating high school seniors and current college students who are interested in pursuing business careers. The scholarship is open to all U.S. citizens and residents, and applicants must provide a photo of themselves as well as proof of enrollment at an accredited 2 or 4-year college or university. Aside from completing an application, which can be found on jetsurety.com, students are also required to provide a 250 to 500 word essay on this question. How has the development of technology affected your decision, if at all, in your chosen field of study? And how is the future landscape of technological advancement shaping your future career? The deadline is on January 31st, which I know is pretty soon, but don't worry, it's a short application. But just because it's short doesn't mean you shouldn't take it seriously. Put your best foot forward and put your best application forward. I wish you good luck and I'll see you next time.
Well, unfortunately, this concludes our weekly news show for this week, but I think that this show was a great way to welcome back into the week, not only for me coming back, but just after, you know, MLK weekend last week and us getting into the beginning of the Mardi Gras season, which for the Purple Knights will begin next Friday night for a Slidell parade. I can't think of the name right now, but that's when we will, our Mardi Gras season will officially start. Mm-hmm. And so after that, then we have, of course, all the parades. We have Endymion, Zulu, Femme Fatale, all types of balls. And we're in Rex this year, too. So it's like we have a lot going on in the Purple Night Nation on the Mardi Gras side. And then we have the basketball team is doing really good right now. We just beat Holy Cross 61-56 on Tuesday night. Of course, we do have some other games coming up. So it's a lot going on, as always.
A whole lot going on.
And I think sometimes we forget how much is going on until we actually see the dates on the calendar.
It's so much fun. It's like, what can you do? Like Mardi Gras, going out there, having fun, all the food trucks, everything out there just supporting. Like, there's stuff everywhere. Like, I could walk down somewhere and just see food trucks, beads. Like, there's so much stuff that's going on. It's just a lot of colorful and playful things out there.
Mardi Gras definitely is a family event, and we want to see everyone out there in Mardi Gras attire, particularly Purple Night Mardi Gras attire, to see everybody out there supporting the March 100 and staying safe. I'm Malcolm Farrellette.
And I'm Josiah Butch.
And remember to rise, sons, and excel in all areas. Have a great weekend, y'all.
Purple on the left side, gold on the right. Purple on the left side, gold on the right. Purple on the left side, gold on the right. Purple on the left side, gold on the right. Purple on the left side.